I remember too well when the Feast of Christ the King of the Universe was observed, all the gold came out of the sacristy. Gold vestments and gold here and crowns being set up of different kinds to put emphasis on this title of Jesus, King of the Jews. And yet, what is the one title he constantly refused to receive for himself? King. What went wrong here? And I'm more grateful that in our more current days, our scriptures make it a little more clear that Jesus is the shepherd, the merciful one, the healer, the one who is like us in all things but sin. And I very intentionally have this stole, which I use today. It just seems to me it says much more about Jesus as, if we want to use the title, King of the Universe, in that he was a shepherd. What do shepherds do? They have responsibility for the flock, for their well-being, that they get fed, that they're cared for, that they're not put into a place of danger. Is that not Jesus' role as a leader, as a good shepherd among us? And then this other side of the stole shows Jesus as the healer, the forgiver, the one who is compassionate. Now that too is certainly much more the title of king, if you want to use that word, for Jesus. I was forced to be in Hawaii a few weeks ago. First time I had the opportunity to be there, and it was made more possible because one of my classmates covers a priest there for about 2 months when he's away visiting with his family on the mainland. And so it just worked out that I was able to stay there, save a lot of money. I was amazed at how many homeless people are right there in downtown Honolulu. I've even was told by folks who live there that some of the cities on the mainland give a one-way ticket to homeless to Hawaii. Weather-wise, it's very boring there. Every single day, it's like 83, 84, 85, 86 degrees, or it's a low of 72, 73, 74 degrees. Much better to be here. We have snow and cold and winter. But back to the note, if in fact that is true, that some of our cities, especially on the western end of the mainland, send homeless people with a one-way ticket, because in that kind of environment, you can live outside, continue to be homeless. Pope Francis just recently, he was asked specifically about leaders in our world. Of every nation, he wasn't pointing out any one particular person. But he said, he's not going to be in judgment. He said, but we want to see how the poor are taken care of. That is a sign of the success or the intent of those who are our world leaders. And there I was in this environment. To go a little bit down the road to Waikiki Beach, it's not all the pretty people there, let me assure you. But it was just over the top from what I am familiar with. And then just a few miles away, we have this intense sense of poverty. The poor are among us. And Jesus' role was not just hanging out with the hoity-toity, right? But he constantly found himself being criticized and ridiculed for being among the other people. That's great that he did that, because it surely shows us the example of what it means. In our gospel reading, we have several times, if you are the king, if you are, and Jesus is accused of being someone he is not. In Luke's gospel, there is a lot of emphasis that Jesus is the new Adam, because the first Adam messed it all up for us. Adam, according to the scriptural account in the book of Genesis, he wanted more. He wanted to be equal to God. Well, that isn't going to work. He wanted to control everything. That wasn't going to work. And every Adam kept undoing all the possibilities of what it could have been. And so Luke writes with that sense that Jesus is the new Adam, the one who is obedient to the Father, the one who doesn't take glory to himself, the one who is really servant to others. So if that's the kind of kingdom, if you will, that Jesus is wanting us to be part of, maybe we all have to once again re-examine our own consciences and our own mode and life and way of living in order for it to be much more in conformity with the kingdom that Jesus was establishing on the face of the earth. Now, these three young men's going to be baptized today. They're entering into the midst of that whole kingdom of God, not of gold crowns and gold garments and so on, but of service, ministry, compassion, love, healing, forgiveness, and all the things we ideally expect of all of those who are part of the kingdom of God here on earth, even before we touch the afterlife and in the eternal kingdom of God. So it's not about royalty in the sense we might stereotype it for Jesus, but a cross, a crown of thorns, is his crown of glory. So contradictory to what the world might envision for the Son of God, who calls us his brothers and sisters, who calls us to follow in his footsteps to the eternal kingdom.